and staying the people who work at this particular company. We're really talking about one person, the owner of this company, the person who leads this company, who has represented the main problem here. The other co-workers, the other people who work there, have treated Lacey well. I think you're going to hear that. But the owner of this company has not. And that's what we're here today to discuss. So first, let me give you a bit of background information, then you'll hear more detail from Lacey about exactly what she experienced. So Lacey grew up here in Georgia, between South Carolina and Georgia, spent most of her life in Augusta. She worked for a restaurant called Farmhaus Burgers, which, as you may know, is owned by Frog Hollow Hospitality Group, all based here in Augusta. She worked for them for several months, and she'd done about a year, and she'd done a great job. She was given new responsibilities, she was given more hours, she was doing a great job, and she had no problems at that job. Everything was going well for her there, thank God. But then last summer, Lacey, as part of her personal spiritual journey, started researching different faiths, and she came to embrace the religion of Islam. That is her right as an American, that was her personal decision to do so. She, after embracing the religion of Islam, decided she wanted to start dressing a little more modestly and to start covering her hair. Now, when she did that, she did exactly what employees are supposed to do. They let their employer know, for religious reasons, I need to wear a certain type of clothing. Can I have permission to do so? But when Lacey did what she was supposed to do, Farmhaus Burgers did not do what it was supposed to do. First, they just essentially ignored the request, did not give her approval to wear the scarf, and so she started wearing it in her off-duty hours, wearing a smaller version of it to try to make sure she was following her faith while not interfering with her employer's requirements. But then eventually she finally did hear from the owner of Farmhaus Burgers, who pulled her into a private meeting, alone, no one else there, and proceeded to ask her, what's this about, in reference to the hair scarf that she was wearing. And when she told him what he already knew, that she was a Muslim and that she was wearing this for religious reasons, he proceeded to berate her, to harass her, to criticize her, to compare her to the Taliban, and to tell her that if she was going to keep wearing that hijab, he might have to put her in the back. And that this was so disappointing because she'd been doing a great job at work. Now, Lacey, you know, anyone who experienced that in the workplace is going to feel threatened, is going to feel afraid, but she held it together. She got out of that room safely. And shortly thereafter, another employee at Farmhaus Burgers came to her and apologized to her for what she'd experienced. And Lacey hoped that that would be the end of it, that she would no longer experience harassment, no longer experience discrimination. But after that, her boss, the owner of Farmhaus Burgers, would start showing up during her work shifts, stare at her, roll his eyes at her, make faces at her. And other coworkers warned her that this was being done purposefully, that the owner of Farmhaus Burgers had told these other coworkers, at least one, that if she's not going to quit, I'm going to make her quit. I'm going to force her out. And that's exactly what happened. By the time August came around, Lacey had had enough. She resigned, left Farmhaus Burgers, and alerted us to what happened. We have filed a complaint with the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission. Our staff attorney, Marcus Aquadro, will explain a bit more about that process, what it entails, and what happens next. But I really wanted you to hear the story from Lacey herself. I wanted you to hear, you know, who she is, her life experiences briefly, and what she went through. And I want you to know we're here today because her story is not unique. Things like this happen to far too many people of various faiths, Jewish, Christian, Sikh, Muslim, anyone can experience discrimination. Lacey obviously being a Muslim, Muslims being targeted at a very high rate in this country, sadly it's happened to her. But I'm happy she's here and brave enough to speak up to hopefully make sure this does not happen to anyone else again. So I'm going to turn over now to Lacey. The podium is yours.
As Mr. Mitchell said, my name is Lacey Enevoldsen. I'm 20 years old and I was born and raised in South Carolina. I stayed in that area for my entire life. For a short time, I did go off to Florida for a little bit, but in May of 2017, I came back to the area, and that is when I began working for Farmhaus Burgers. I was extremely excited about the opportunity, given that it is a restaurant that promotes local eating and supporting local businesses. And I do see that as very important, especially in a smallish city like Augusta, but it's big enough we can kind of get things going. I met, you know, wonderful guests. They were always fantastic, and I've built bonds with them that I really hate. I don't see them every day anymore. Still remember all their orders, quite frankly. But while I was there, I did very well. I very quickly went from a food runner to their head cashier position, and was really just there. I did, you know, embrace Islam in June of 2017, which was a very positive experience for the most part. Any close friends and family, things like that, as they found out, they were very happy for me and very supportive, including my coworkers and management as well at my work. But while I was there, I did begin wearing my hijab or headscarf, you know, to work off duty while I was kind of filling it out before I was wearing it full time. And it was then that a general manager of the establishment approached me and just asked me about it and congratulated me once I informed him that I had embraced Islam. And it was a very positive, happy conversation. But he decided to follow that up with warning me about the owner, Sean Wight. He asked me if the owner had seen it yet or if the owner was aware that I was a Muslim. And, you know, I let him know that I had not approached the owners yet, but I was planning to. And from that point, I was warned that the owner, Sean Wight, would not like that very much. And I was kind of suggested at that point to go ahead and start looking elsewhere. He actually mentioned other restaurants that may be hiring. Just for my benefit at that point. I didn't let that bother me too much. I tried to assume the best of people and the best of things. You know, I had heard rumors of discriminatory actions that had been done by Sean Wight, and I had seen some things myself, but I was hoping it was maybe more of the past thing and he had moved past that as a person and that we were evolving to a better status. But unfortunately, I met with a co-owner to discuss the fact that I did want to begin wearing my headscarf to work for religious reasons, and we had a very pleasant meeting. I explained, you know, what the hijab was, why it was necessary, what exactly it meant to become a Muslim and all that. You know, I gave a little rundown and she was very positive and it was pleasant all around. And from that point, I offered to send pictures of me wearing different types of hijabs, just showing the different ways they can be styled so that they could have a little bit more of a pick of how it would go with the uniform, to give them a little bit more control in that, because I knew it was something they had not encountered thus far. And so I wanted it to be as professional and as smooth as possible of the transition. And so we agreed that I would send in the pictures so they could see how we'd wear them and I could, you know, show that it would match the uniform and things like that. And we went about our ways, and I was very relieved. I told one of my coworkers from there, one of my close friends, I let him know like right after. I sent him a text, and I was super excited because I was like, oh, it went well, because I had been nervous for weeks building up to it. And so the next day, I sent the pictures of me in the headscarf, and I did not receive any response for a few days. So I sent another email with a picture of me in a head wrap. So it was a little bit more modern, a little bit less obvious, you know, asking if I could at least wear that while they discuss the terms of my actual headscarf itself, so that they could get more comfortable and acquainted with it. And I received an email back to that, just letting me know that it would be discussed. And then I received no email for a few more days. So after waiting for a response, and when I still didn't receive one, I knew it was in my constitutional rights to begin wearing it anyways. So I decided to wear just a black head wrap to work that day to kind of fill it out and see how others felt about it and my coworkers, which overall was a very pleasant experience. The coworkers really didn't acknowledge it. The managers didn't. The guests were more than pleasant. It all went very well. And so after that, I did begin just wearing my traditional headscarf like I'm wearing now. I just wore it all black to match the uniform and we went about our day. It was a few weeks, about a week after that, on July 5th, 2018, is when Sean White took me into the office. I was sitting at the bar at Farmhouse eating lunch on my off time. I was just in my regular clothes, in which I was wearing, you know, my headscarf, and I wasn't on the clock. He came over and asked if I was done eating and said that he wanted to have a chit chat with me. And so I just went ahead and stopped eating, because I would rather go ahead and get a chit chat out of the way. And we went into the office, which there are no cameras, and he brought no one else in to the office to experience the conversation. He decided to kind of hover over me, lean on the shelf, and he motioned to my head and asked, "What's all this?" And I informed him, just as I informed the other owner that had already approached, that it was my hijab, and I explained the conditions of it. And that I had already asked to be wearing it, that I had just been waiting on response, and so I had began wearing it at that point. And from that point, it took a very south turn that I wasn't necessarily expecting. He decided to inform me that he had friends at some point that had to deal with a Taliban, and he compared me to the Taliban and the religion in which I was embracing to the Taliban, which I saw as obscene and unnecessary within a workplace environment. From there, he let me know that it was such a shame that I was such a good employee because he couldn't have somebody like me representing his company. He let me know he did not want a Muslim representing his company. And that was really hard because I was a very passionate employee. I loved people and I loved serving good food and I loved the connections that I had been building. And I knew right then it was kind of crashing down on me. He proceeded just to let me know that he would have to just find somewhere in the back for me, that he did not want me at his establishment anymore, that all the precursors to this, all the work that I had done and the validation that I had been given for doing my job really did not mean anything now that this scarf was on my head. I didn't say anything during the meeting. I didn't really know how to respond to something like that. I left pretty hastily and I just got out. And I went and immediately began applying for jobs. When I came back a few hours later, because it was about to be my shift, the manager on duty at the time, he pulled me into the same office and apologized to me for the things that Sean had said. And you know, he didn't have much to say other than how sorry he was. And he assured me that, you know, my hours weren't going to be cut, that Sean can't do the things that he wants to say. He said that the thing Sean said was just a knee jerk, trying to scare me out of it, so that maybe I would just go ahead and leave it and not keep pursuing wearing my headscarf to work. You know, I just nodded my head like a good employee and left and went and worked my shift. From that point on though, Sean numerously came into the building and would either stand at the side of the cashier section or at the back to just stare at me and watch. And he would come around and he was constantly just, you know, when somebody's standing over your shoulder watching you and rolling their eyes or getting annoyed when you're doing anything that normally was fine, but now suddenly it's not okay. You know, managers felt the need to warn me anytime Sean came in the building so that I could go and stand my post and look as perfect as possible because they knew it was just a matter of time. Is he going to say something else to me or what? I actually had a manager approach a close friend to ask them if I was looking for new work yet. Because he was concerned that Sean was trying to push me out of the establishment, and he suggested that I did go ahead and begin finding new work. I kind of just accepted it for what it was, and I did begin to prepare, you know, to have to find somewhere else. I was called into the HR office July 25th from there, and I was asked about the situation further, in which I informed them of what had happened and made sure they had all the details. And it wasn't long after that, it was just a few days, that I did end up resigning, which I really didn't want to do. You know, like Edward said, Augusta is actually an amazing place. There is ridiculous diversity here that makes it as beautiful as it is. And I would like to think that business owners would also respect that, and they would respect their guests enough to not be doing that type of thing when they're taking in their guest money. As much as I loved the establishment and I loved the guests, you know, I did end up leaving. And after leaving, it was a relief that was finally off my shoulders. And I did get very lucky to be able to come in contact with CAIR for them to take on my case so that it actually can be made known. Because like you said, this isn't a very unique case. It's really common to hear about Muslim women that as soon as they put on the headscarf, issues start to arise. And I just really hope that something like this will stop future things like this happening. I feel like it's a very easy thing to accommodate in pretty much all situations. It doesn't make me any less or any more than anything. It just makes me a little bit more covered, if anything else. I think Augusta is better than that. They deserve better than that. And I would hope that business owners start to give the guests and the citizens of the areas something better than that.
Thank you, Lacey. Thank you so much for sharing that and sharing your story. And again, that story, you know, is not unique. We've seen it too many times privately in our work.